While addressing the media today at the police headquarters in Naguru, police spokesperson Fred Enanga said preliminary findings implicate Abby Musinguzi, also known as Abitex, on all the loopholes in the Freedom City stampede that led to the death of 11 people and left over 10 seriously injured. Enanga noted that on the 31st of December 2022, the management of Freedom City handed over the venue that was hired to Abitex Promotions.
So the findings also indicate that Abitex was warned about the potential crowd control and safety concerns by police, and the preventive guidelines were clearly spelled out to him during the concert preparations and made aware of their duty to hire private security, provide emergency medical services, control crowds, forge evacuation routes, and cautioned also about multiple disorders and other key concerns. As indicated in the earlier statements we made, we've established that the organizers put profits over the safety of revelers and concert goers. They disregarded part of the safety and security controls and issued a dangerous directive to the bouncers of Uber to lock all the other four doors. That led to the death of 11 concert goers.
Enanga says facts gathered indicate that the proprietor of Freedom City Hall, John Sebalamu, recorded a statement and also handed over an agreement between Freedom City and Abitex, which had two clear terms and conditions where he was asked to provide adequate security and crowd control for the event, which he didn't fulfill. Besides, there was no standby medical team to handle emergencies.
There was also negligence on the part of the organizers for overcrowding beyond the 15,000 capacity. There was lack of standby medical staff, and the bouncers were not very skilled. They admitted children who were not in the company of parents or responsible persons, among others. Then the MC, Juco Francis Elvis, also recklessly informed revelers to move out of the hall to the children's yard without alerting the bouncers and local guards to open the gate. So as a result, we had a dash whereby people got trampled, trapped, and piled upon.
With all the findings, the police considered slapping Abitex with additional charges after the death toll rose to 11 following the death of a three-year-old. Now Abitex faces 11 counts of rash and negligence that led to the death of 11 people, plus 8 counts of rash and negligence that led to injury of 8 people.
We also registered the death of a three-year-old female juvenile. The names were not given, who was in the company of the mother called Naka Anjako Immaculate. She succumbed to the injuries from Mulago Hospital. So this now brings the number of deaths to 11, which means 11 counts of rash and negligent acts causing death.
It should be noted that Abitex was last week sent to Luzira Prison after being arraigned before the Machindi Chief Magistrate's Court and charged over the New Year Eve tragedy at Freedom City Mall. Also arrested was the MC of the event, among other organizers. Meanwhile, the traffic police have introduced badges for all passenger bus drivers in an effort to reduce road carnage. A few years ago, the Ministry of Works and Transport required that all taxi and passenger bus drivers were required to display the badges in their vehicles at all times. However, the ministry later removed the badges.
Traffic and Road Safety has taken a decision to the driver badge reinstatement. We are going to reinstate the driver badge immediately. All bus owners are hereby instructed to submit particulars of all bus drivers to the Ministry of Works and Transport for verification. This started on 6th January 2023. This exercise will only last for 1 week. Thereafter, no bus driver will be allowed on the road without a badge.
Meanwhile, in the first week of the year 2023, a total of 340 road crashes were registered, and in these, 79 people died and over 240 were seriously injured. The crashes have been attributed to reckless driving. Report by Rachel Nachuala for the news.